to vote for freedom.
How come you're not suing in the Wisconsin counties that use this? Why are you only doing a recount?
And excuse me, that we're not out to the questions at this point. So excuse me, we're not at the questions at this point. My name is Jenna Ellis, and I'm the senior legal advisor to the Trump campaign. And I'd like to just explain now where we've been and where we're at and what you can expect from this process. So what you have heard, I'm sure, in the fake newspapers tomorrow will be one of two things. Either there was not sufficient evidence that we've presented, or we spoke too long. Okay? So what you've heard now is basically an opening statement. This is what you can expect to see when we get to court to actually have a full trial on the merits, to actually show this evidence in court and prove our case. This is not a Law and Order episode where everything is neatly wrapped up in 60 minutes. For those of you who are here in this room or have maybe tuned out in other networks, clearly you've never been court reporters. Trials take time. Putting on evidence takes time. This is basically an opening statement so the American people can understand what the networks have been hiding and what they refuse to cover, because all of your fake news headlines are dancing around the merits of this case and are trying to delegitimize what we are doing here. Let me be very clear that our objective is to make sure to preserve and protect election integrity. President Trump has been saying from day one that this is about maintaining free and fair elections in this country. It is not about overturning an outcome. It is about making sure that election integrity is preserved, and every American should want that. If every American is not on board with that, you have to ask yourself why. And if your fake news network is not covering this or allowing you to cover it fairly and accurately, you should ask yourself why. This is absolutely a legitimate legal basis. We have been asked to provide an entire case that generally would take years in civil litigation. I've been a prosecutor. I have tried cases with far simpler facts. One thing happened in a matter of minutes, and it still takes days. And we go through a jury process. This is the court of public opinion right now. We are not trying our case in the court of public opinion, because if we were, we would get unbiased jurors. I would strike 99% of you from the jury, and I would be allowed to because of the fake news coverage you provide. You are not unbiased jurors. And until you step out of your role as a journalist and actually go into a courtroom and you are a judge on a bench that has sworn an oath to be unbiased in our separation of powers, then your opinion does not matter. The facts matter, the truth matters, and if you are fair reporters, you will cover that fairly and appropriately, and you will allow coverage of our media team here and our legal team. That is absolutely shocking that all you cover are around the margins, and I've seen all of you taking pictures right now, and I can anticipate what your headlines are going to be. If you are not willing to talk about the evidence that has been presented, then that is absolutely unacceptable for journalistic standards. This is an opening statement. This is something where we have told you what the evidence will show, and we have given you a brief description. That happens in a courtroom all the time, where that's not the fact-finding process. That is just an overview. That is what we have given you today because the American people deserve to know what we have uncovered in the last couple of weeks. Remember, this is such a short time frame, and this is an elite strike force team that is working on behalf of the president and the campaign to make sure that our Constitution is protected. We are a nation of rules, not a nation of rulers. There is not someone that just gets to pick who the next president is outside the will of the American people. And that is our task, because when we talk about voter fraud, it's actually election official fraud. That cannot stand. The Constitution requires that the state legislatures are the ones that make election law. It still has to go by the U.S. Constitution. But what has happened in this case is that state and local level officials and all the way up have changed the rules. That's what the Democrats do. If they don't like the rules, they change them. And they change them at the last minute. They manipulate them. They want to tear down our American system. Our founders were so brilliant that they anticipated this, that there would be corruption, there would be foreign influence, there would be attempts to manipulate the outcome of the election, especially with who they called our chief magistrate. I would encourage all of you to go home and actually read Alexander Hamilton's Federalist 68 and see what he described as an advocacy position to adopt and ratify the Electoral College and the process by which we select our president. We select our president through the Electoral College not because it disenfranchises voters, but because it is a security mechanism for exactly the type of corruption that we are uncovering. And every American should be grateful and thankful that our founders had the foresight to put in those protections and provisions to make sure that your legitimate legal vote is not disenfranchised. That is what we are advocating for. We want to make sure to protect election integrity. And your president, President Trump, we are so proud that he is in this fight because he understands that when he swore his oath of office, he swore an oath to uphold and defend the United States Constitution. That is what he is doing. And that is what we are doing. We are confident that through this multiple pathway to victory, we will get to the actual outcome that the evidence shows. But this is not about overturning an election on our part. It's about making sure that we protect and preserve free and fair elections for all future American elections. If the United States caves to corruption or this type of election integrity disaster, then no election will be secure from here on out. And we all need to be keenly aware of that. We are the representatives here that are standing in this gap and defending President Trump and defending you, the American people, at the end of the day. This is ultimately about the United States of America. And we want to make sure to protect and defend that. And as my colleagues have said, we will not back down. We won't be intimidated. President Trump will not be intimidated. You, the American people, should not be intimidated. You, the press, should cover this fairly and should know that this matters to election integrity, and it matters to the future of our nation. So we have given you an overview, but recognize this is not a court of law. We will get there, and we have time, and we have constitutional provisions that will step in when we show the corruption and the irredeemably challenged and overturned votes that are absolutely corrupt in all of these counties. It is irredeemably compromised. We will show that, but you have to give us that opportunity. This has been just our opening statement, and we have an opportunity to get there, and we have time, and we will do that. This is the United States of America, and we stand proudly for President Donald J. Trump. Thank you.